The Necromunda Underhive box set contains loads of cool scenery pieces, and in this video we're going to show you a great method of painting those bulkheads and also the tentacle that you get in the set as well. Now for the bulkheads, the first thing we need to do is give them a heavy dry brush of lead belcher, and then we're going to use some Balthazar gold to pick out some details on them. After that we'll be ready to shade them, first of all with Norn oil followed by Agrax Earth shade, and then we're going to highlight them by dry brushing them with Necron compound. Finally, we just need a small amount of Abaddon black to paint in a few final details. But we need to start out with lead belcher, and as I say, I'm going to apply a heavy dry brush over them using a large dry brush. Now I've undercoated the bulkhead here with Chaos Black spray, and the reason for this, rather than undercoating it with lead belcher, is because I want it to have a very slightly rough texture, which is great for aged metal. So dry brushing like this will give us that texture. So what you do is just get some paint on your brush and then use some tissue to work it in amongst the bristles like this to get rid of the excess paint. And once you've done so, you're ready to start applying it. And the application for this is quite heavy, in a circular motion like this, to really start to build up the colour across the whole scenery piece. Once you've finished building up that colour, you can now add some Balthazar gold to break up larger areas of silver. And great things to paint with this colour are things such as pipes just down here. Once you're happy with your base colours, you're ready to apply a generous coat of Norn oil all over the bulkhead, applied with a large shade brush. Now, as you can see, this is going to be a bit messy, so if you haven't already, be sure to put down some old newspaper to protect your work surface. Once that shade is completely dry, you're ready to add a second coat of shade, but this time Agrax Earth shade, applied in exactly the same way. The Agrax Earth shade is now completely dry too, and you can see just how dirty and grimy it's made the bulkhead look. Now we just need to make the details pop out a little bit more, and for this we're going to apply a light dry brush of Necron compound. Don't be too heavy with this because you don't want to make it too bright. And finally, paint in any small details like the glass of this light or any cables with Abaddon black. And with that, the bulkhead is complete. But at this point, if you want to, you can add an extra effect to it in the form of some weathering, because we're now going to add some rust to it. Now for this, what we need is scrag brown, and what we're going to do is water it down heavily on our palette. So just get a small amount with a small airbrush and just put it onto your palette there like that. Then add a good amount of water to it. You want to go for two brushfuls like this, so you see I've got a really thin version of the paint. Then just make sure your brush isn't overloaded with it, and what you're looking to do is to paint it into areas where water would collect. So a great example would be just down here. All I'm going to do is just run it into the recess there like that. They're really simple to do, but also really useful as well for adding an extra effect, where if you look for some rivets like this, what you can do is paint some around it, then just run it straight down, and this way you get the impression of the trail of water building up and rusting over time. I've finished adding the rust, and you can see just how cool it looks adding that subtle weathering to the bulkhead. And it's complete now, ready for some battles to take place around it in the Underhive. Now there's another cool piece of scenery you get in the set, and that's a tentacle, and we're going to show you quickly how to paint that now. Before you paint the tentacle itself though, you do need to paint the manhole cover around it, which you can see is exactly what I've done in exactly the same way that we did the bulkhead. Now for the tentacle, we need to start out with a base coat of Caliban Green, and then we're going to start adding some Warpstone Glow to it to start to brighten up the top of it. Then we'll shade all over it with Beltan Green, add some more Warpstone Glow to make it a little bit brighter again towards the top, and then highlight the green with Moot Green. After this, we just need some Xerius Purple, and this is going to be for those spots that are on the side of it. But we need to start out with our base coat of Caliban Green, which I'm going to be applying with my medium base brush, and you want to use your palette here to get the paint ready. So get some on there like that. Add a small amount of water to the mix just to thin it down so it's a bit smoother, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting this all over the tentacle, being as neat as you can when you get close to those silver parts that we've completed already. I applied two coats of Caliban Green to build the colour up to this point, and now we're ready to add some Warpstone Glow. Now I'm going to stipple this on using a small dry brush, which I've prepared in the same way as I would if I was going to be dry brushing the colour, and what I want to do is just start stabbing this onto the tentacle like this on the upper half of it. This way I'm going to slowly build up that green, and I avoid getting a solid line between the lighter green and the darker green, giving a much more natural look. Carry on building up that Warpstone Glow until you get to this point, and once you've done so, you're ready to apply a coat of Beltan Green all over the tentacle. Allow the Beltan Green to dry completely, and then we're going to go back to Warpstone Glow to stipple it on again, but this time focus just a little bit further towards the top of the tentacle. With that done, we're now ready to highlight the green parts of the tentacle with Moot Green. And for the spines, what we want to do is just paint a line just going across the top of them like that, just for that sharpest detail on there. But you also want to highlight these little pitted parts we've got along the side here. And for this, you just need to go all the way around them like this. And finally, paint some Zarya's purple into these recessed little craters on the side of the tentacle. Now, once you've done this, if you want to, you can paint a coat of Ardcoat gloss varnish over it to give it a kind of slimy shine. But if you choose to do so, just be careful not to get any of it onto the metal. I decided to apply a coat of Ardcoat to give the tentacle that slimy shine, and with that, the tentacle's complete, and really, that's all you need to know to paint your Necromunda scenery. As you've seen, it's really easy to get a great result and really fun as well, so we really hope you guys enjoy painting yours, and we'll see you all again soon.